Angeles. You're listening to the Alex Scheafer Hour on Coagula.com. We're live at the Hive Gallery. I'm looking at a film crew right now. There's a boom mic right above me. You can't see all this. And I'm looking at a painter who's looking at me. Right now I'm kind of trying to keep my head still.
Well, this will be interesting for me because I'm trying to paint and talk at the same time, which I'm getting better at, but it's still difficult. So it'll be, some of my answers will be not entirely comprehensive, if you will.
No, I know, because I do a lot of that talking and painting. I think part of it came from doing, from teaching. You have to kind of learn to articulate and talk while you're doing it. And then also working plein air, you have to kind of deal with people just walking around going, what are you doing?
Yeah, I've done some plein air painting, and that's tough. It's tough to get anything done and deal with
Immediately, right off of the top, right at the tip of my tongue, is John Kilduff.
Okay, John Kilduff. I'm very familiar with him.
Yeah.
He's a good buddy of mine.
I think he's a genius. I really do.
Really?
Not only the way that he has found a means to express his sort of performance needs.
Yes.
You know, he has that in his personality.
Absolutely.
He has to do it. But he's found a way to get that out in kind of like a lo-fi, low-budget way.
Yes.
But then at the same time, the guy can paint the hell out of a still life, a landscape, an urban landscape.
Yeah.
He really is like a, kind of like a drunken master sort of kung fu guy. I'm not saying he drinks a lot, but you know what I mean?
I know exactly what you mean.
He powers through
the work
and
looks like
gets it done.
He's drinking something really good.
But I would probably say another person that would be completely on the other side of the spectrum, I mean, still working realistically, in a sense, but way more experimental, would be Carol Powell. Powell, she does these gigantic fabric, kind of collage sewn together, wall hangings with collage and painting. And I think that she's a real, again, a genius, and work that is completely different, you know.
Who else can you think of? Putting you on the spot. Well, you'll think of somebody as we're talking.
Yeah, there's, I know a bunch of really good landscape painters. I think William Ray, Jose DeJuan, you know, like Google those guys.
What do you think about some of the real traditional plein air guys, you know, Ken Oster or Nian Satu or, you know, more of the traditional.
Right, that's kind of like the sort of the California Art Club side of things.
Exactly, California Art Club side of things, precisely. You're more contemporary.
I wouldn't, you know, like call anyone out specifically.
Right.
But I would say that I think that scene is a little bit sort of stuck in a particular aesthetic or approach to painting. And you know, which they're into that.
Yeah.
You know? And they're enjoying that, but I just can't imagine sort of
to do that every day.
Yeah, not being able to let yourself just go haywire and Fauve or Matisse or just, you know, add Reinhardt, whatever you need to do.
Right,
you know?
Exactly.
It's like, does everything have to be like John Sargent and Sproia?
Yeah, exactly.
As a student, I think the teachers that I liked the most or had the most influence on me were Richard Bunkel, Dan McCaw, Vern Wilson. They
Now, is Dan the father, or who, which one?
Dan was is the oldest is of all the macaws.
Okay.
Yeah, he's the father. All
right.
And, you know, a real painterly painter.
Oh, yeah, they're all good.
Richard Bunkle was just painted like, you know, it just looked like plaster, cement, you know, the paint was so dense. And I think it really got me into paint.
Yeah.
You know, as opposed to into modeling, you know.
Right.
I would love to have had a drink with Titian.
Titian? Sweet.
Young and old Titian.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so maybe even at the same time. How about that? Young Titian and old Titian, all, it would be a threesome, all having, like, wine or something in Venice. The contemporary artist that I could punch in the face,
Can you look at me while you tell us?
Right. I would probably say, you know, easy targets would be the biggies like Damien Hirst, Murakami, Jeff Koons. I mean, I think they've done more to erode art out of what I think is important and just kind of drag it into this realm of pure concept.
Yeah.
And I think it's just slowly made contemporary art more, just alienated it from more and more people. But then ironically, at the same time, they've managed to sell it for more and more money than ever, you know.
Yeah. What accounts for that, you think?
Well, I think they just figured out how to rig the whole system.
Uh-huh.
You know. It's like mortgage-backed securities or something. You got the ratings agencies rubber stamping them. You got the banks are bundling them. But it's kind of like it's a bubble, you know.
Yeah, you think it's a
bubble. Like Eli Broad's art collection is too big to fail now.
But think about what's going on Grand and, you know, some of the plans that Broad has and whatnot.
Yeah.
And I mean, you know, I could see LA being quite the, you know, the art world behemoth more so than it even is now, you know.
Yeah, I mean,
if it's played right,
say,
it could be ruined too.
That whole part of town, I just can't stand that part of downtown.
Yeah. Right.
I mean, I wish I could have seen what Figueroa was like in the 60s.
Yeah, right.
Because they just turned it into this, you can't, it just feels like you're walking next to the freeway, you know? And yeah. Everything is sort of, you can't park anywhere, and it's all cement.
You've been asked about the connection with the Richer LACMA in Los Angeles County Museum on fire.
Yeah, I mean, that was like, Ed Richer is a million miles away in my mind. Like,
I imagine.
I don't even think of him as an LA painter. It's weird.
Really?
You know? Yeah. But I mean, I definitely think he captured a mood of LA, which is kind of like stark. It can be very cold, you know,
yes.
Isolated.
His work is cool in a sense, you know what I mean? I mean, it's not cool as in hip, it's cool as in it's hard edge, it's mechanical looking, it takes the motion out of the process, which I think is what a lot of contemporary critics found so interesting, was it looked like a machine had done some of these paintings. There was no life to them, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't know if you see that, but if you look at the Los Angeles County Museum of Art, the building is so mechanically done.
Yeah, it almost looks like how someone would do a drawing of a.
Yeah, it looks architectural.
Like a machine part or something.
Yes, like a machine part, exactly.
What do they call, like, schematic?
A schematic or a diagram or a, you know, like a blueprint or something.
Right.
Something.
Yeah. Oh my God, this hour is almost up. I'm just gonna let us know it's 1:57. Time flies when you're having fun.
Yes, it is. Yes, it does.
Here it is. Reaction shot. That is awesome! Holy crap, man. That is great. These brushstrokes are genius. The face. Look, that is an amazing likeness.
When they see it, they'll see how I ripped you off.
Dude, there is no such thing as ripping off, man. They're like, that's Picasso's big.
Well, you gotta
like,
see it.
Message.
You gotta see the painting if you think I ripped them off or not. Now they have to see it. No, I got inspired, so what can I say?